Hallo und willkommen zurück zu Divinity Original Sin 2 und wir sind in der Taverne noch in Driftwood und werden jetzt das obere Stockwerk uns anschauen, dort mit den Leuten reden. Da ist ja auch noch die Prostituierte und danach wird es dann wahrscheinlich in den Keller gehen und ich vermute mal, dass da dann eine Art Arena-Kampf auf uns wartet. Aber erstmal reden wir hier oben.
The town is poor, but this room is rich.
Wer bist du?
A weathered woman in a dirty sea captain's tunic babbles breathlessly to herself.
The bell rings a warning and the tide is on the turn. And I without my compass.
If she held a compass, she must have been the captain. Ask her where her ship lies berthed. Burst?
The ship is in the locker, on the bottom in the rocky shallows, and all are drowned but me. And yet, can you hear? The bell rings on. The bell haunts me yet, and it would drive me mad.
Tell her you hear no bell.
Perhaps I am already mad. But I swear I hear the bells. Please, make it stop.
She buries her head in her hands and cries.
Make it stop.
Drowning her sorrows. Missing Magisters. We have strong evidence to suggest that Vivia, the
Who
cook, the Black Stick Ball Tavern, is responsible for the Magister disappearances. Drowning her sorrows. Captain Almohima. We encountered a disturbed sea captain named Ableweather at the Black Bull Tavern. She claims to be haunted by the bells of her lost ship. Captain Ableweather asks us to try and stop the ringing ship bell that torments her. Die irritieren mit ihrem Gelaber. Dann gucken wir mal gerade, ob das hier irgendwas zutage fördert. Ja, genau, der ist am Rumbimmeln.
A ghostly seaman stares at the captain, his lip curled in a malevolent grin, his eyes wide with hate, and all the time he rings his bell. He registers your presence. His head swivels towards you.
Spoke to the lady captain, didn't you? I seen you cozying up. Are you her man, or sail you with us?
Tell him you don't like the sea. Bad things happen at sea. Tell him you'll gladly sail if you're sure of your captain. Tell him it's time to set sail himself. His life is over. He can go to the Hall of Echoes.
I'm doing my duty here, I am. I'm the lookout and I'm ringing the bell. Rocks ahead, Captain. There's no lighthouse here. Rocks ahead.
Finesse, tell him he's promoted to captain. Time for him to join his ship. Constitution, praise him for his sterling performance of his duties. Tell him he's earned shore leave. Memory, soldier, intimidating his captain? That's gross insubordination. He should be whipped. Tell him he's dead. It's time to move on. He's promoted to captain.
But I'm on duty here. There are rocks ahead and the captain must know it.
Tell him he is relieved.
He blinks once, twice. A single salty tear drips from one ghostly eye. The bell falls silent. He raises a finger to his temple in salute and fades away.
Woof.
She babbles breathlessly on, barely aware you're there.
My ears are still a-ringing.
Tell her the bell should ring no more.
And I have you to thank for it? Then thank you, I surely do. That accursed bell lies with the peacemaker on the bottom in the rocky shallows. My compass lies there too.
Ask about her compass. Ask her what happened to the peacemaker's cargo. If there was one, it must have salvage value.
She goes white as the proverbial ghost.
You've got no call to go looking for no cargo. Far as anyone's concerned, we sail with an empty hold, and if there's anything left to salvage, you leave it where it is. Heed me. Leave the cargo of the peacemaker alone.
She turns away. Conversation over.
Hätten wir vielleicht anders machen sollen? It's hard to tell what animal these are from, but they are sure strong and sturdy and not slimy at all. Elven Menaulion, das ist ein Speer, nützt mir auch nicht viel. Ein Chainhelm, der ist auch ein ganz normaler Grützehelm. Wizard Leggings. Na ja. Okay, ja, ich lade mal und guck mal, ob wir das anders reden können. Wenn wir da noch irgendwie was anderes rausfischen können.
She babbles breath.
The bell rings.
A ghostly seaman.
Spoke to the lady captain, didn't you? I seen you cozy. I'm doing my duty, but I'm on.
He blinks. He raises a.
My ears ringing that the infernal bell is gone.
Was? There are signs of sores in the area. Explain yourself. Oops. Shrug and say you don't know anything about sores. You're covered with a stink of sores. We've got prison cells just for your sort. Try to talk your way out of the situation. Finesse suggests that a strip search might be more revealing. Okay. Oh well, you make convincing argument off with you. Tschüss. Yeah.
She babbles breathlessly on. Barely aware you're there.
My ears are still, and I have you. That accursed bell lies with the peacemaker on the bottom in the rocky shallows. My compass lies there too.
Claim you're an expert salvager. You could easily find the compass for her if she tells you where to look.
Let me mark your chart. But you be warned. Stay off the wreck itself. Let her lie as a monument to her dead crew. And as testament to my mistake.
Ask about a compass.
The compass surely lies on the bottom, near where the ship was wrecked. Take it with my blessing, if you can find it. My sailing days are done.
Machen wir jetzt das mit dem Salvage Value?
She goes white.
You've got no heed me.
She turns away.
Mhm. Finesse 12. Ja, nehmen wir den trotzdem. Okay. Schwupp. Können wir den ja wohl verkaufen.
The experience of a lifetime, is it? It's disgusting, that's what it is.
Und ja, das war's dann auch. Magister's Seal.
I'll knock it if I want. Even I haven't tried it.
You've got to pick who you can trust.
Ich bin mir gerade nicht sicher, wieso ich den nicht anhöre. So, wir haben jetzt jedenfalls. Okay, können wir jetzt nicht rauswechseln. Na gut. Irgendwo sollen wir ein Schiff finden. Drowning her sorrows. Captain, we managed to stop the spirit of First Mate Stubbs from ringing the ship bell. Captain Abelweather told us where your ship sank west along the coast. It supposedly contains a magic compass.
Oh, forget it.
Okay, dann gehen wir mal rüber. Magister Eden.
Yeah? What do you want?
Hero, tell her you want the very best of for all people.
Huh. I want another beer and a bowl of stew. Which of us is more likely to get what they want, do you think?
Remark that optimism is a moral duty.
Guess that makes me a sinner. Perhaps you can help us settle an argument.
Ask what the disagreement is.
Thatcher here is one of my dearest friends, but she isn't the brightest.
Thatcher grins, hello.
Our mate Boris got posted to Fort Joy for consorting with lizards. And Thatcher here still fancies a turn around the park with Lovric's lizard. I say she'd be sleeping with the enemy. What say you?
They look at you expectantly.
Tell them you think they should go consort with themselves or with each other. Shrug, in times like these, who cares who does what with whom? Say that if they're asking you for advice, they must know the situation's dodgy. Am I this?
Thatcher looks victorious. Eden looks annoyed.
You're as bad as she is. Get lost then, you're no use to me.
Eden turns back to her drink. Thatcher smiles goodbye.
Stick to your own kind is my advice.
She tips you a wink, then turns away.
Naja, whatever, okay. Dann gucken wir mal in den Raum hier rein. Ist auch offen. Flight of the Phoenix. A dozing adventurer.
Weathered and rugged, the man sleeps soundly. He mumbles in his slumber.
There's bad things in the caves. Bad dwarf things.
Mephin B.
As the head said, don't open the chest.
He goes back to sleep.
Und das ist aber ganz böse am Leuchten.
The man sleeps on.
Blood and oil do mix, after all.
Wake him up.
His eyes open, but he doesn't see you.
Ask what he means, blood and oil don't mix, surely.
The island is ruined and doesn't have a name. Don't go there.
Shout at him to wake up.
Startled, he opens his eyes, but he's staring into the distance. He's still asleep.
Ask about this ruined, nameless island.
There's no graveyard on the island. Stay away from the graveyard.
Try to wake him up once more.
His eyes flicker open, but he looks like he's still asleep.
Ask where this graveyard is and why one should stay away from it.
Sawdust and wolves, mother. Sawdust and wolves.
Try to wake him up again.
His eyes flick wide open, but he's clearly asleep.
Ask about these dusty wolves.
Arcs for Lucian's Day sounds nice, mother.
Try to wake him up once
his
more.
His eyes flicker open. But he looks like he's still asleep.
Ask if he'll be in Arx on Lucian's Day.
Leave me alone, mother.
Try to wake him up again.
His eyes flick wide open, but he's clearly asleep.
Tell him you're not his mother.
Get away from my chest.
He goes back to sleep.
Flight of the Phoenix. Jetzt bin ich intrigued.
The chest won't open.
Swear at it under your breath. Kick it.
It doesn't open.
Try to lever the lid open with your fingers or a blade or whatever handy.
It doesn't budge.
Study the chest. It seems different, yet familiar.
You notice the lack of scuffing around the lock. It would seem that this chest does not require a key.
Ask it nicely to open, please.
Speak the word, and I shall open.
Wonder aloud if the box didn't just speak to you.
Speak the word, the magic word, and I shall open.
It wants a magic word. Try the last thing the sleeping man said. Mother.
No.
Try open.
No.
Unclose.
No.
Reveal.
No.
Disgorge.
Still no.
Go counterintuitive. Try close.
I am already closed.
On a hunch, try an ancient word for open.
I did not understand. Do you want a buffalo?
Swear in frustration. Try kshmarch again. Only this time, carefully enunciate the syllables.
Is your buffalo unwell?
Swear in frustration.
Do not profane. Speak the word, and I shall open.
Try chest.
I am a chest.
Wonder aloud if you're not on something of a loser here.
This seems likely.
Remark that you could probably stand around guessing forever and get nowhere.
Yes, you could.
Give up.
An excellent choice.
Uh-huh.
The chest won't open, and you don't know the...
No. Yes, an excellent.
Okay, es sind keine anderen Optionen. Dann gucken wir nochmal, ob wir mit dem reden können.
The man sleeps on.
Ghost cheese. Mother, are you mad?
Nudge him with your knee.
Huh? What?
Ask him for the magic word for the chest.
He wakes.
Thief. Mother, there's a thief.
He settles back to sleep.
Tell him you want the bloody magic word and you want it now. Stroke his face and tell him you're his mother, then ask him for the magic word to his chest. Tell him you want the bloody magic word and you want it now. Nehmen wir das hier mal.
He snorts.
Mother, it's so obvious. Speak the word and I shall open.
Also nur the word sagen.
Then goes back to sleep.
Uh-huh.
The chest sits there, refusing to open.
Try the word.
You speak the word. I open. For your safety, please stand back.
Stand back.
The lock unlocks with the tiniest click.
Oh, forget it. Der braucht die sicher nicht mehr. Vielen Dank, dann habe ich dieses Mal tatsächlich was gestohlen. Aber das gehörte wohl dazu. Stolen. Na, okay, dann haben wir hier jetzt ein Item, was als gestohlen gilt. Weiß nicht, was passiert, wenn wir dann da, ob wir dann mal untersucht werden oder sowas. Da gab es halt mal was im Trailer. Aber der ist schon ziemlich gut. Naja. Ja. Behalten wir aber mal hier.
The man slumbers on.
Lean close to his ear and whisper, "Thanks for your stuff."
He stirs.
Mother, no one with ghost cheese has any friends.
And goes back to sleep.
Ja. Ja, gut, dass wir gesprochen haben.
You're willing to risk Fort Joy for one night with a lizard.
Ich geh dann mal. Was ist das? Toiletten? Oh, da geht's nochmal hoch. Mhm. Oh, und das. Da auch noch ein Raum. Okay. Und da sind auch noch zwei. Brax.
That's a shame it is.
An absolute shame.
Ask what they're talking about. What's the shame?
Alexander, slaughtered like a supper lamb. Poor dear.
It ain't right.
It ain't right. Never thought I'd say this. I hope they round up them sorcerers for good. I ain't needing one sick in a void working on me.
You said it, Hilga. You're a true patriot.
Then you're an idiot.
Hilga jabbers excitedly with Brax, but the two go quiet as you approach.
Gibt nichts zu kaufen. Na gut. Die ist anscheinend legal zu knacken. Holla die Waldfee. Wem gehört denn diese Rumpelkammer? Die ist auf jeden Fall fett eingerichtet. Dann fangen wir mal an, hier alles einzusammeln.
Boring.
Toll. Sort.
And you can't be too careful, you know? If they can get Alexander, they can get any of us.
Wieso ist denn da die Tür aufgegangen? Jack. Das ist wieder Schrott, brauchen wir nicht. rotten eggs.
Boring.
Überladen. Dieses Bild kann man nicht mitnehmen. Da hat noch jemand über einen Kompass geredet. Puff. Da liegt auch so ein Face Ripper rum.
Lucky find.
Klicker, 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 klicker. Ja, ja.
Rubbish.
Scheint mir nicht so voll, dass ich gar nichts daneben kann. Okay, dann Toy Sword. Kann man wohl verkaufen. Whisperwood. Das ist auch stolen. Das lege ich mal weg. Das muss man nicht mitnehmen. On the origins of Lucian. There was a great need, then. Unfathomable forces of darkness, forces so great the seven themselves could not hold them at bay. Began to gather like storm clouds over our great realm, and so they made a decision. They would put their differences, their rivalries, their pride aside and join a single avatar, one, who could unite their power into a single almighty force of order and good. Lucian was chosen from among those summoned. Lucian the worthy, Lucian the holy, seven times divine was he, and yet still he fell. And you can't be too careful, you know? If I can get Alexander. Die linke Tasche ist das. Okay. Ark's City Guide. This thick and peppy guide recommends visiting a number of Ark's landmarks, including its famed cathedral, especially on Lucian's Day, the city's busiest holiday. It also makes a cautionary statement not to attempt a challenge called the Path of Blood and ask Arhu, keeper of Lucian's crypt, about the history of the trial. Nägel rüber. Worn teddy bear. A worn and flayed teddy bear, clearly loved by generations of children. Guide to Trolls. Das hatten wir schon mal. Das kann ich also auch verkaufen. Empty Honey Jar. Das kann rüber. Toy Sword kann weg. Book. Rock of Ages. Hubert Herrin ruminates on the powers of certain sorcerers to manipulate the very earth beneath their feet. Great boulders may fly through the air, the dirt may mute and poison the unwary, and a warrior may become a walking fortified redoubt. Hubert goes to great pains to seem both disgusted and baffled, but mostly he seems fascinated. Ab in die Tasche. Dann haben wir irgend so einen Fisch. Verkaufen, verkaufen. Das ist auch zum Verkaufen. Dann haben wir Warfare. On the first page you read Warfare by Jay Hanneman. After that, pages upon pages of words and verses about death, demons, destruction and war are recorded. Judging, gloating, accepting, analyzing. Some seemingly random lines inspire you to create grenades based on poison and intestines, and you decide to try it out next time you have the necessary ingredients. Zack. So, dann haben wir Sheet of Paper. Dwarven Dagger, können wir verkaufen. Wobei, Sheet of Paper können wir rübergeben. Rotten Eggs, die gehen dahin. Das geht dahin. Das geht dahin. Das auch. Das hier ist wieder zum Ticken. Der Schlüssel, Suit Key. The key, exceedingly smooth and polished as though it had been rubbed in many a pocket over the years. Das ist einfach nur eine Box, die 50 wiegt. Weil. Ist das Blatt? Ja. Dwarfendagger kann weg. Weg. Shawl kann weg. Das können wir mal rübergeben. Soap. Soap. Scrub all you like. The sauce hounds can still catch the scent of sauce. Weg. Journal. But the Blanchard boy, it was lame and had no use of his left foot anyway, and I gave him plenty of amber ale to numb the pain as well. Quite kind of me, all things considered. Mother's punishments were formidable. Next time I'll do what must needs to be done. So that she'll never find out. I can only blame myself for leaving the Blanchard boy alive. Bottle. I can deduct one recipe from this book, but this reads more like a puzzle than a recipe. I will have to experiment with what I can learn from these rhymes. Creepy dead magic requires one shadow and ghoulish ingredients, skulls and bone and marrow. With parchment and paper, you can then compose malevolent magic and sinister scrolls. Rüber. Dann kann das auch darüber. Dann haben wir hier den Face Ripper. Blows up your target. Das hat der aber ja auch schon. Das ist eigentlich Unsinn. Why the seven gods exist now. Was? Why the seven gods exist not now, nor never have. Gods? Ha! Fairy tales, phantoms, what more? Who could mistake the mysteries of nature for the hands of a ghost? The bounty and beauty of nature. It seems foolish to assign this wonder to some unknown and unknowing entity. Some may request I cast my mind's gaze not upon the lilies of the field, but upon the soul of man and the higher beasts. Hier, was hat man schon mal? But this I submit, that I have inspected the inner workings of man and beasts, living and dead, and I found no soul, only squirming red and bleeding purple. There was no god in those private chambers. Ja, ich, das haben wir schon. Aber gut, alles in die Tasche. Bucket kann weg. A wooden doll. Die, keine Ahnung, ob die irgendeinen Belang haben. Wahrscheinlich nicht. Ist genauso wenig. Bedlinen. Das ist auch stolen. Müssen wir auch nicht haben. Book of Rhyme. Within the children's rhymes written on the pages, you find a curious and charm titled Alice Allison. Don't get close to Malice Alice, else she'll turn you to a toad. Don't you dare kick Alice Malice, or you'll be all pigeon-toed. She'll sick her rats and call a cat. She'll feed you to camp of bats. Don't say hi to Malice Alice, or you'll fly off as a crow. Crow. Toy Shield. Das kann wohl auch weg. Cup. Weg. Worte an Pest, ich glaube, da haben wir auch schon mehrere von, mit der Sekunde. Laboratory Stuff. Lalala. Fishbone. Kitchen Pot. Cradleson Silly Book of Blanks. Aha. Was ist das? Blank Card.
Boring.
Boring. Okay.
Curiosity kills the cat, or gets it sent to Fort Joy.
Okay, empty bottle. Rüber. Das hier kann weg. Cool.
You got a pick and rüber.
So. Cradles and Silly Books of Blanks. Die, okay, das hatten wir auch schon mal.
And you can't be too careful, you know? If they can get Alexander, they can get any of us.
You're right about that.
Oh, right about that. Okay, dann gehen wir mal da rein.
What the devil are you staring at?
Your beard, my lord. It seems less lush somehow.
Here now. Have you a reason for barging into my room, sir? When one's in a small town, one must expect small town manners, I see.
He squints at you and laughs. Looking closer, you see the man is wearing a very obvious fake beard. Behind the atrocious fox hair, you recognize the mischievous twinkling eyes of a lone wolf, Callow.
Ifan, forgive my style. I look a right pickled pepper pot, don't I?
Shallow, ask why the hell he is pretending to be some rich knob. Tell him he looks ridiculous. Did he get his disguise by trimming a horse tail? Pretend not to know who he is and bow as if towards nobility. Niemals zweiter.
Look, we can't all be follically gifted like yourself, Ben Mezd. Oh, nice job on Alexander, by the way. That'll net you a pretty penny, I'd wager.
Tell him you haven't quite yet succeeded in killing Alexander, more's the pity. Ask where he heard about that.
Oh, we all knew you got the contract, so when news arrived about his, untimely passing, I put two and two together. I may not be as sharp as your claws, but I'm no dolt. So what next? Grapevine says you know the whereabouts of more Godwoken. Guess you'll be taking them on over Roost's way, eh?
Tell him you're keen to take the Godwoken to Roost, but where is he? Muse that you're not so too sure what you plan to do now.
Wow, inspiring attitude. Sure, Roost'll love to hear it. You know where he's at? Him and the boys are camped out at an abandoned sawmill not too far from here.
Baron hunkers down and sketches a rough map from your present location on the floor using an apple, some playing cards, and a fistful of threads pulled up from the carpet.
Suppose you'd best get moving, huh? And I'd best get back to living the no-thrills-barred life of this chump.
Compliment him on his impersonation. Time to hit the road. Straighten his fake mustache and stride off. Compliment him on his impersonation.
Ah, you know how it is. Pretend you own the place and a surprisingly large number of people just go along with it. But I won't lie, the beard does go down well with the ladies.
Mm-hmm. Time to hit the road.
Baron laughs and swats you away.
Uh-huh. Spirit of Baron Lavera. Das war dann wohl der echte.
I am Baron Lavere. I am Baron Lavere. Not he. Not he. I am Baron Lavere.
Ask the spirit to explain himself. You already met with a man called Baron Lavere.
No, an imposter is he. A lone wolf in my own sheep's clothing. Bejeweled is he with a false name. Draped is his back with a false mantle. Bedecked are his cheeks with a false beard. Murderer, thief, imposter. I am Baron Lavere.
Ask the spirit of Baron Livia why a lone wolf murdered him.
A rival's revenge? Another merchant's madness? Oh, the fever of gold is reason's bane. But it matters no longer what drove them to daggers. It matters who drove them into my flesh. You who hears the laments of the dead, avenge me. Kill the false baron. Give me back my name.
Take your leave.
Please, avenge me.
Uh-huh. Guardsman Melek.
Better watch yourself, lad. Got greedy eyes on you. Sets me on edge.
My lord.
It seems less lush somehow. Doesn't this room strike you as eerie? There's a chill in the air, a deeper darkness in the shadows. But, of course, I should hold my tongue and stand guard. All's well, as long as my lord's coffers are safe.
Okay, vielleicht können wir dem ja sagen, dass sie selber Godwalken sind und dann umbringen.
The trickster, formerly known as Callow, stands in Baron Levere's robes, twirling his fake moustache with what can only be described as supreme panache.
Say that you're not sure how to say this exactly, but Baron's ghost is haunting him.
Creepy.
Agree. You'll try to get rid of it. Tell him you can kind of see the ghost's point of view.
Come on. How many ghosts do you think have haunted you?
Leave him to his work.
Imposter wolf, ripper of flesh, taker of names, accurse him! Please, avenge me!
The trickster, formerly known as Callow, stands in Baron Levere's robes, twirling his fake moustache with what can only be described as supreme panache.
Here now. When one's in a small town, one must expect small town manners, I see. Have you a reason for barging into my room, madam?
Fain befuddlement, the innkeeper told you this is your room.
Ah, so it's dear Prudence who's responsible for our confusion. Odd, she's usually as strict as a taxman. Still, no harm done, I suppose. I may as well introduce myself. Baron Levere, at your service.
You notice two other men in the room. Note they look well armed.
Of course they are, as good bodyguards should be. I'm a wealthy man, and wealthy men need protection, especially if they accompany their wealth. The merchant's burden, you see. He must escort his merchandise, always.
Say that if he's a merchant, you wouldn't mind having a look at his wares.
Music to my ears. A happy accident after all, you're barging into my room. If there's anything else you need, know you're always welcome.
Uh-huh. Okay. Das Ding ist schon sehr gut. Vermutlich sollte ich das auch kaufen. Kostet 2000 noch was. Aber wenn ich den jetzt umbringe, hat sich das natürlich auch erledigt. Das ist auch... Naja, gut. Ist halt vor allem auch teuer. Helm of Protection. Ja, ich sollte erstmal gucken und schauen, was ich mit dem anstelle, wenn ich ihn jetzt umbringe. Ask Baron where his travels are taking him.
Travels, you say? And why would you assume I'm a traveling man?
The state of his boots point out they look quite travel-worn.
He laughs heartily.
Of all things, I wouldn't have thought my boots would give me away, but you're quite right, of course. I am traveling, yes, to Arx. Lucian's Day will be upon us soon, a celebration no man with a heart that is both as pious and mercantile as mine should miss.
Inquire after Lucian's Day and his reason for attending.
I go because it is every citizen's duty, our communal obligation to chant the rites of the return and pray for Lucian's divine resurrection. That said, I do have more secular motivations as well. Arx positively overflows with pilgrims during the festival, pilgrims and their purses. As a merchant, it is quite my favorite day of the year.
Mm-hmm. Take your leave, and yet?
Ah, looking for another trade?
Nah.
Here now, when one's in a... Have you a reason for barging into my room, sir?
You didn't mean to offend. Apologize das letzte Mal. Say you're no other reason than natural curiosity.
Which is what killed the cat, remember? Still, no harm done, I suppose. I may as well introduce myself. Baron.
Okay, dann machen wir das mal anders. Dann muss ich jetzt mal das laden. Ich würde den gerne umbringen, aber mich angreifen lassen, wenn es geht. Und da mal gucken, was wir da für Optionen haben. Der hatte mir allerdings jetzt auch gerade irgendeinen Weg gezeigt. Na gut, finde ich sowieso. Denke ich.
What the devil are you staring at?
Guck mal, was da passiert, wenn man das so macht mit dem...
He squints.
Ifan, forgive my style. Look, we can't... Oh, nice job on Alexander, by the way. That'll net you a pretty penny, I'd wager. Oh, we all... So what next? Grapevine says you know the whereabouts of more Godwoken. Guess you'll be taking them on over Roost's way, eh?
Tell him that you're actually Godwoken yourself.
His eyes widen and he whistles low, the movement causing the fake beard to slip sideways on his face.
Well, now... Be nice knowing you, Ifan. But you're a goner now, no matter what. And I might as well be the one to collect on the contract.
Ja, okay. Damit wird er böse. Und dann können wir den umbringen. Dann werden wir aber mit Sicherheit nicht seine Waren bekommen. Deshalb macht es wahrscheinlich Sinn, zuerst mit einem anderen zu reden, die Armbrust zu kaufen und den dann mit seiner Armbrust zu erschießen. Denn die war ja gut.
What the devil are you staring at?
Erstmal reden wir mit dem.
I am Baron Lavier. I an imposter, bejeweled murderer, thief, a rival, but it matters you who please.
It's as lush as it's always been. Now train your eyes on my treasures, not my person.
Doesn't this room struck but of
Here now. Have you a reason for barging into my room, sir? When one's in a small town, one must expect small town manners, I see.
Okay, dann kaufen wir hier halt direkt. Death's Knell. Okay. Da kann man auch noch einen Edelstein einbauen. Ja, bezahlen müssen wir das sowieso, von daher. Na, wobei, ne, machen wir mit Gold. Ja, accept. Dann kann ich das aber jetzt nicht ausrüsten.
He squints.
Ifan! Forgive my style. Look, we can't... Oh, nice job on Alexander, by the way. That'll net you... Oh, we all... So what next?
His eyes...
Well, be nice...
Atrophy. Destroys magic armor each turn. Das ist durch die Vakuum-Aura. Okay, der hat 126. Die haben alle verhältnismäßig wenig Magieschutz. Dum, 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 dum. Dann müsste ich denen jetzt eigentlich Magieschaden zufügen. Da habe ich aber jetzt wenige Optionen für. Suffocating. Oh, und das zieht dann auch Punkte ab hier. Das macht nur Schaden an Gegnern. Dann machen wir das. Und ziemlich gut Schaden. Nehmen wir den mal. Schockt. Okay, er ist gerade hingefallen, muss also seine Runde bewenden, um aufzustehen. Stefano. Aber wir können jetzt... machen wir das am besten. Den ja können wir petrifieren. Den hier müssten wir... ne, dann machen wir was anderes. Nehmen wir uns den. Wobei wir leider kein Feuer oder sowas haben. Ich spring den mal auf die Nase. Da ist jetzt Feuer. Dann machen wir jetzt Folgendes. Ich springe da hin. Werd mir das Feuer nehmen. Und dann auf den Herrn da schießen. Was aber nichts gebracht hat, wahrscheinlich wegen dem Flaming Skin. Nehmen wir den. Moment, das war was? Dazing Bolt. Electrical Bolt falls from the sky. Das kommt wahrscheinlich nicht durch. Ja, sind jetzt jedenfalls alle ohne magische Rüstung. Da musste man ein Ziel aussuchen. Das macht eigentlich keinen Sinn. Nehmen wir Uncanny Evasion. So. Trifft ihr damit beide? Nee. Long range attack that deals damage to a single target, leaving them blind and burning. Bams. Dann machen wir das hier auf alle. Alle geht nicht, dann nehmen wir das auf die. Okay, ja, den können wir jetzt anfangen runter zu prügeln. Oder aber, wir werden jetzt anfangen, CC zu halten. Petrified. Und dann knüppeln wir da mal drauf. Der kann sich jetzt noch enragen. Weil ich nicht weiß, wie sinnvoll das ist, weil das, glaube ich, nach einer Runde wieder weg ist. Ach, es hat sogar zwei gekostet. Naja, okay. Too bad. Hallo. Chicken. Resist by Physical. Wir machen auch das hier. Der will nicht. Ach, der hatte wieder neue Magical Armor, das ist ja fies. Nehmen wir den mal, werfen den dazu. Das würde den schaden. Werfen wir mal einfach den. Die hat gerade nichts zu tun. Damit greife ich auch den Geist an. Ne, so nicht. Mhm. 18 noch. Machen wir mal hier den. Heilt er sich durch den Flash Sacrifice? Vielleicht durch das Blut. Okay, wir machen jetzt den. Mhm. Der müsste doch jetzt eigentlich auch petrified sein. Wieso habe ich jetzt diesen Petrify Skill nicht? Ach so, weil der gemutet ist. Okay. Mhm. Ja gut, viel aushalten tut er ja nicht mehr. Dann ruße ich den da jetzt einfach mal um. Noch 24 hat der. Können wir den wieder machen? Blub. Und Stufe gestiegen. Der ist noch petrified. Der auch eigentlich. Das ist eigentlich wurscht, wenn ich angreife. Moskitoschwarm.
I'm ready.
Ja. Machen wir den noch dazu. Wer kann dem jetzt die Augen ausstechen? Kann man den nicht angreifen, weil der Petrified ist oder was? Doch. Geblendet. Und tschüss. Jetzt du noch. Der hängt fest oder was? Okay, ne, er hängt nicht fest, aber da ist in keiner Position, um den angreifen zu können. Machen wir das mal so. In fact. Quatsch. 22 übrig. Ganz leicht flankiert. Und weg bist du. Ja, vielleicht hätten wir die Armbrust bekommen, aber die ist jetzt hier auch nicht bei. War jedenfalls auch ein ziemlich einfacher Kampf. Ja, vielen Dank. Wuff. Ja, und jetzt können wir den Rest des Raumes auch noch looten. Ich mach mal gerade die Tür zu. Eigentlich wollte ich nur die Löffel klauen. Apple.
This again.
Den Rest kann ich da drauf lassen. Glaube ich. So, was sagst du? Bist du happy?
The imposter is dead. My name is mine once more. You who suckers the souls of the dead, I thank you. I am Baron Levere. In the halls, I'll be Baron Levere.
Wupp. Gern geschehen. A rare prey. We defeated Windigo. She seemed to have been begging for the forgiveness of some unknown deity before she attacked. What kind of god would the Lenetic like that worship? Blah blah. Baron Levere informed us that the lone wolves have been tasked with killing Godwoken. The snoozing adventurer. In a guest room upstairs at the Black Bull Tavern, we encountered a man who is mumbling to himself in his sleep. We came across a locked chest that spoke to us, demanding the password. Such sophisticated precautions must surely hit a rich bounty. Ja, das hatten wir. Ja gut, das hier war jetzt eher nix, aber wir haben jetzt noch dieses Schriftstück. You know what to do. Infiltrate the tavern at Driftwood. Find a mark whose identity can serve you. Then trap and kill Godwoken. Top price from our client for each one. Bring their heads to me at the sawmill to cash in. Aha. A rare prey. I discovered that someone is paying mercenaries to kill Godwoken and bring their heads to certain R at a sawmill. It'll be ill-advised not to find the sawmill and find out who wants me dead. Dann geben wir hier erstmal den Kram wieder rüber. Jetzt kann man Glass of Wine. Konsum. Drunk. Expensive Wine. Den verkaufen wir lieber direkt. Fancy Key. Der geht da in den Rucksack. Kaufen. Gutted Fish. Mug of Beer verkaufen. Lone Wolf Mark. Gag Order. Aha. Gut, dann werde ich hier einen Schnitt machen und dann werden wir beim nächsten Mal uns die Gegenstände näher anschauen, die einen Stufenanstieg machen, hier das weiter plündern und weiter hochgehen. Also, bis zum nächsten Mal.